You've seen them on rooftops, in fields, along roadsides, and you'll be seeing more of them. Solar photovoltaic, PV installations are on the rise everywhere. Let's see how they work. The base of this system is solar cells. Solar cells contain a semiconductor material that conducts electricity only when energy, in this case sunlight, is provided. When the semiconductor is exposed to sunlight, it absorbs the light, transferring the energy to negatively charged particles called electrons. The electrons flow through the semiconductor as electrical current because other layers of the PV cells are designed to extract the current from the semiconductor. Then the current flows through metal contacts, the grid-like lines on a solar cell. These solar cells are connected together to make a module, and when modules are connected, they make a solar system. A typical residential rooftop solar system has about 20 modules. The current flows from this collection of PV cells as direct current, or DC, and needs to be changed to alternating current, or AC, to be used in different electric devices. So, the current needs to go to an inverter. The inverter converts the direct current, DC, to an alternating current, AC. An inverter accomplishes the DC to AC conversion by switching the direction of a DC input back and forth very rapidly. As a result, a DC input becomes an AC input. In addition, filters and other electronics can be used to produce a voltage that varies as a clean, repeating sine wave that can be injected into the power grid. The sine wave is a shape or pattern the voltage makes over time, and it's the pattern of power that the grid can use without damaging electrical equipment, which is built to operate at certain frequencies and voltages. If you have a household solar system, your inverter probably performs several functions. In addition to converting your solar energy into AC power, it can monitor the system and provide a portal for communication with computer networks. Solar plus battery storage systems rely on advanced inverters to operate without any support from the grid in case of outages, if they are designed to do so. And this is how a solar panel system works, and as long as the sunlight continues to reach the module and the circuit is connected, electricity will continue to be generated.